Hello and greetings from Iceland. It's time for a volcano update, and things are not cooling down. In fact, a volcanologist just stated this afternoon that we could be looking at hours rather than days, and he also stated that this could go off with a major show that could turn nasty. But as always, I'm not sure that his colleagues are of the same opinion. But let's go and see the town with some help from my footage from yesterday. Here we are overlooking the mountain Thorbjörn, and this is where scientists have situated what they call a magma sill, or a sheet of lava that has been squeezing its way between the existing layers and stretches all the way under the Blue Lagoon. But the seismic unrest is, however, quite widespread. It looks to me as the magma is just trying to find the weakest part of the crust, but some or all of the earthquakes could also be triggered by changes in tensions in the crust due to this intrusion. And this location still remains as the most likely spot for an eruption. But as for last night, the seismic unrest started strong again, and the earthquakes were moving west for a while to the Eldwerp craters. Then they sort of faded out around noon and started again just before a set down with this voiceover. And I did actually take the thermal drone out for a spin yesterday, but like I suspected, it was getting limited results since it was sunny, but also cold, so I did manage to do some mapping to use later on. But the next scan will be done tonight. And I did actually do a few trips with the other drone, and I want to have good B-rolls by hand for my updates, covering each and every hill there, to explain the situation from the drone. And since we are so close to the next eruption, according to some scientists, I need to correct a little mistake from my last update. There is already a webcam up and running up on the mountain Thorbjörn, and I'm linking to it, of course. It is overlooking the Blue Lagoon and the Svartsengi power plant from somewhere around here. And this mountain is actually where this whole scenario started on the peninsula in 2020. Mount Thorbjörn was formed under glacier, like many other formations on the peninsula. But this tectonic feature on top of it makes it look like nothing else around here. And one of those fractures is actually called the Thieves' Gap, because this fracture was occupied by thieves according to old tales. And every now and then they came to town, Grindavik, to get a cheap sheep from some of the local farmers. And during those days, sheep theft was a serious offense. So finally they were captured by the locals while bathing in a hot spring between the Blue Lagoon and Mount Thorbjörn and executed by hanging. And the Blue Lagoon, it is not a natural lagoon. It came into being when the mineral-rich wastewater from the factory was pumped up onto this lava field. And before it became a tourist sensation, the young people from town would go there during weekends in the middle of the night and have a good time. So the history of the Blue Lagoon is actually a fun story that I would like to make into a video someday. And yesterday there was a meeting in town with the villagers and experts, and one of the main topics was the power plant. Or would it cease to exist like the Blue Lagoon would also do? In 1976, this was the world's first geothermal power plant for electric power generators and hot water for district heating, and today it produces 150 megawatts for the district heating and 75 megawatts of electricity. And Iceland's first renewable methanol plant is also here, and it's a spin-off from the big factory like the Blue Lagoon, which is, like many of you already know, Iceland's most popular tourist spot. So there is a lot at stake, and it's a huge workplace when we include the hotel and the spa. Many of them are from Grindavik, so this situation looks bad for the local economy. And with the knowledge that geologists have today, this would have been built on higher ground. And this shot tells us a bit about the problem. In the background, up on this hill, we have the hot water supply tank for Grindavik. This is a mountain pass, the main road to Grindavik, and the power station sits in this depression in the land. But it might be a sort of good news that magma accumulation around here would have to reach some enormous levels to flow over this gap and towards the town. But if an eruption occurs further west, the town is at risk from that direction. So this is extremely complicated. Or, as I mentioned in my last update, it can be just a matter of few tens of meters where the eruption comes up, whether this will be a disaster or a major disaster. And the worst case scenario is the town, of course, and the harbor. No harbor, no town. And this is how it looks to me now. And I'm getting ready to document whatever is about to hit us this time and do a night scan with the thermal camera. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.